Hello and welcome to Success Stories. Success Stories is that show where students who have passed the CS executive or professional share their experience of how they cleared the exam, which will motivate you in your journey. And joining me today is Susan George from Chennai. Hello, Susan, and congratulations on passing in the CS executive.
Thank you so much, sir. It's my pleasure to be here.
So great. So Susan, we have seen you right from CSEET stage. So I still remember that you have just out of CSEET and even spoke to your father on how the journey will be for CS. Is it a good course and all of that? And now you have passed the CS executive. So how does it feel both for you and in the family that you have come so fast?
Yes, so it's truly a memorable journey. Even I was very skeptical about joining this course, seeing the pass percentage. But then right now, as I passed one module of executive, it's really, really very memorable, especially my parents. They have been a huge support. So when my dad checked the result and when he told I passed, everyone was very happy. Especially, I guess my dad was more happier than me. He was really very happy.
Okay, great. Very good to know that. So are you also doing your BCom or degree along with CS, or are you doing only CS?
So right now I'm just a full-time CS student. So what I have planned is, once I clear the executive, that is, I have module one also pending, so that will be ready in June. So God willingly, if I pass, then I would do the IGNO BCom. ICSI has an MOU with IGNO. So for students who have cleared the executive, they could do the BCom, just four papers, almost 12 to 16 papers are exempted. So I'm planning to do that, sir. So I'm not joined any other college.
Very good. In fact, probably you'll be getting more time to study because you don't have the college. Because many students who go to college, their common concern for not being able to clear is most of the time goes for BCom and assignments. And most of those assignments are of zero value when you go to the job market. But unfortunately, that is there. And the advantage for you is you can study and give all your time for the company secretary course. Good. It's actually a brave decision, and I would invite everyone else who's watching this to consider it as a serious option, just like how Susan has done. Many more students are doing it. And we see that students who are able to give more time are able to clear the exams without any problems. So that is the reason you should consider it. Now, Susan, can you tell us a little bit about each of the subjects? Now that you have cleared one of the modules, each of the subjects, what was your approach? Which subject you found difficult and what did you do?
So right from when I registered for executive, I was very scared about accounts. I was for sure that I won't even get 20 marks in accounts. I was really very scared. So I took the bull by the horn. So I prepared accounts really well. I spent a lot of time for it. So as it is an MCQ paper, so what I did was, I was blessed with a wonderful faculty. So during the classes, we used to solve MCQs. And once one chapter was done, example, share capital chapter is quite a huge chapter. So once that chapter was over, I used to solve the MCQs. Something like around, like I used to refer the guideline answers, scanners, past papers. I used to do that chapter wise. So solving more MCQs gave me the confidence. So I realized that it's not tough as it sounds. I was feeling it. So solving MCQs for CMA really helped me so much that it felt that it would be easy to clear. And for FMSM, SM is one subject which all of us take it very lightly. So something that I did for SM was, when I read the module, the ICSI module for the first time, I recorded my phone. So whenever I was free, I used to listen to it because reading theory sometimes might be boring. So I just whenever possible while I'm traveling or when something or the other, I just used to listen to the SM lecture, the recording. So that really helped me because for SM especially, all the options A, B, C, D looks very similar. Everything seems to be the right answer.
Correct.
Yeah.
Yes.
And it's like they just take one line from the module and then just erase one word and make it fill in the blanks.
Right.
So going through the module helped so much for SM. And FM, I used to solve long numericals. and I used to solve mini mock papers. I used to always solve, rather than solving mock papers, I used to solve past year papers and the guideline answers provided by ICSI. And for EBCL, I gave more importance for Part B, Competition Act, because in one chapter, it's coming for 25 marks. So whenever I used to study EBCL, Competition Act, I used to always study Competition Act. So maybe like other chapters, probably I studied like one, I've read once or twice, but Competition Act, I've read like 5 to 6 times. So while writing the exam also, I wrote the Part B first. So that gave me a lot of confidence that I did Part B well, so I could do other subjects well. And for SLCM, I focused on numericals too. Practicing the numericals twice or thrice gave an upper hand for the paper. And it's just the understanding the concepts though. So in this, especially in CS, there's nothing called this is a tough subject, this is an easy subject. All the subjects are very easy to understand. It's just that you got to retain it and you got to remember it. So revision would be a key, just remembering and just going through the points. I guess that is a key, sir. There's nothing called tough and easy. It's just your mindset.
Okay, very good. So now that you told us your approach for each of the subjects, many students who are watching this will ask, like, generally, how was your time management in terms of your schedule? Like from the time you get up till the time you go to bed, how did your day look like?
So I was more of a night person. So I used to study at night. Maybe I used to start studying around 11 p.m. to 12 a.m. and it might go like to 4 or 5 a.m. and then I used to sleep. And then once I wake up, I might study for like 2 to 3 hours in the evening. So probably roughly it would be 6 to 7 hours. I haven't spent more time other than that. Like it's probably 6 to 7 hours of study. So as it was, I took online and recorded classes. I could watch it at night because had it been physical classes, I couldn't do that. And then I could watch it at my own pace. And whenever I feel like I want to study, I could study. Whenever I feel I be focused, I could just pause it, take a break and come back and study. And then I used to stay attentive. I used to increase the speed. So in like 1.5x, or if it's very slow, I might get distracted or something. So just to stay focused, I used to increase the speed of 1.5x or sometimes even 2x also. So recorded classes has really helped me so much.
Okay, very good. So next thing, Susan, we want to ask you is, like, did you write mock exams? And was that of anything part of your preparation?
So for this attempt, I wasn't able to do mock exams, but I did refer the past 3 to 4 attempts from the ICSI website. So I downloaded the paper, I read the question, and I read the guideline answers. Other than that, I wasn't able to do the mock exam, but for the next attempt, I'm definitely planning to do it.
Okay, very good. So now you told us about your preparation and also about how you used to study at the night, because many students ask, should we study morning or night? Actually, there's no right answer for that. It is the comfort. Some students are really attentive early in the morning. They can study at, let's say, 4 or 5 in the morning and they can study. And somebody like you is more comfortable at night. So there's nothing right or wrong, whoever is watching this. In fact, I used to study at night when I was doing the CS course. I was also more comfortable in the nighttime. So next thing is we want to understand is, within these 4 subjects of Module 2, which subject do you feel you have given more time compared to the others?
So I've given more time to CMA because, as I told before, I was very scared of the subject. So I gave more preparation. I solved the MCQs twice or thrice. So preparation-wise, I gave more time to CMA.
Okay, very good. So you CMA, like, can you just share your marks within all the 4 subjects which you have got?
So for SLCM, I got 41. For ABCL, I got 46. For CMA, I got 58. And FMSM, I got 59.
So giving more time to CMA has actually helped you to get more marks. And overall, the average is what works out.
Yes. I got an aggregate of 204.
Yes. End of the day, it really doesn't matter. You get 200. 204, 240 or 300, you have passed the exam and
just
that's all matters.
Pass, that's enough.
That's
sir.
All
just
matters.
Seeing the exactly. Pass in the mark sheet. Just
because this is mainly for people who are watching this. They feel, should we get that many marks, this many marks? Come on. The people who pass exam itself are so few. In that, if whatever marks you get, that is what is required for you to become a CS. And that's all they're going to test you. It really doesn't matter about anything else. For whoever's watching this, This is what you should learn. So can you please tell us what was the biggest advantage compared to, I'm sure you have friends who also did BCom, and I don't know, it's very common that parents are pressurized by people around saying that, why don't you make your daughter join a regular college and all that. So how did you and your family deal with this situation, and how did that help you?
So in fact, my dad was the one who told me not to join the college. So it's not me. He was the one, because he is also familiar with this background. He has attempted CMA, cost and management accountant. So he has also, so he knows how things are in this three professional courses. So he is the one, he made me understand. One day he sat down and told me, and he made me understand like how you should just focus on CS, because CS should be a first priority. If I go to college, what if my priority changes? What if the college assignments, classes, cultures, and especially the mode of transport, like once you go, you'll be very tired, and after that, it's very difficult to study. So that was a huge advantage. And yes, sir.
Good. And in fact, for whoever is watching this, very often parents are the ones who make them join college, and students suffer. I have seen that. We have had students who have called us and almost crying, and some have even cried saying that, I want to study CS, but parents are forcing me to go to college, and I know college is of absolutely no use in terms of the syllabus which we are studying and all of that. So you must be really lucky, and we should appreciate the family, because without family support, this is not an easy decision, and you have proved them right by already passing the exam. So in finally coming to the last part of the interview, I'm sure there are some things which you did right and some things which you did not do right during your preparation, and you realized and you corrected yourself. So can you tell what they are? Because whoever is watching this, our intention is very simple. If Susan can do it, or anyone else who is on the student success story interview can do it, the people who are watching this can also do and clear the exam. So that is why we would like you to share this.
Yes. Sometimes I just overworked. Maybe I just tried referring so many books. I guess that was not needed. Just stick to one book. And something that I did right was I just comprised all that I've learned in just one notebook. So the day before the exam, I just got to refer one notebook. So even the institute material, ICSI module, so everything I just comprised in one handwritten note rather than printed. I always prefer handwritten notes. So that is always easier to learn. So just the day before the exam, I just have one book to learn. And I actually wanted to write both groups, but then due to some stuff or the other, I thought it was not practical. But then I was in a delusion whether that I'll be able to do both groups. 8 days continuous would be a strain for me. And my parents were definitely the mentor. Like, I would suggest each and every one to have a mentor, be it a mentorship program or your elder siblings or your seniors or your parents who are very much experienced in this field. So they would tell you what to do and what not to do. Because we joined for the first time. After school, I just joined CS and I don't know anything how the professional course works. So my dad always told me, whenever I used to be off track or deviated, he always pulled me and brought me back to track. So always a mentor is always good for me. I've got my dad. So he always used to say that you have to study, put in more hours, you have to change this attitude, you have to change this, you have to change that. So he has always helped me a lot.
Great. Excellent. So I think you have succinctly told everything about your preparation, and just being out of school, joining CSET, then passing the CS Executive Module 2, and you're still in your teenage years. So I'm sure you'll be able to clear the CS exam very quickly, and we wish you the very best. So that was Susan George from Chennai, who has cleared CS Executive Module 2 and is all set to clear Module 1 in the coming attempt. If you are inspired by the story, make sure that you give a thumbs up. Share this video with your friends and don't forget to subscribe to Ekcel Academy. And for more such videos, ensure that you hit the bell icon after you subscribe. Thank you and all the best to you.